Hey guys, welcome to today's video. So as you can see, I look a little crazy, right? Let's readjust the camera. I look a little crazy because today I'm going to be doing something different. Instead of a vlog, I'm going to be doing an attempt at a wash and go. So I haven't done a wash and go since I first transitioned from relaxed to natural. So I'm going to attempt to do that today, and I don't know how it's going to turn out. So we're going to... You know, we're going to try this together. I've been told by many people on YouTube that my hair does not wash and go because I do have 4B, 4C. And sometimes that 4C is really prominent, even though sometimes a 4B is really prominent. Really, it depends on the day. So, my eyebrows are crazy. Let's fix those. So, anyway. So, yeah. Basically, we're going to be trying to do a wash and go today. So, we're going to go through all the steps. And... we're going to go through all the steps and see what we can accomplish. So, the first thing I'm going to do is obviously wash my hair because this is a really old, really dirty, really disgusting twist out from like 2 weeks ago or a week ago. I don't know if it was a week or two. And it's gross. So, I'm going to wash my hair. I'm not going to be doing like a hair washing scene because like... I don't have time for that, but I'm going to show you guys what I'm going to use to wash my hair. I'm not a shampoo person. Like a lot of naturals on YouTube, I don't like shampoo. I hate it, actually. So, I'm going to be using this as I am Coconut Co-Wash, which is holy grail for me. I think that this shit is thebomb.com. I'm like halfway through a jar, and this slip is amazing. Like, I'm just going to... I mean, I'm sure you guys have seen this 1,000 times before, but like, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Like, it's just, yes, 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 yes. So basically, I'm going to go and wash my hair, and then I will come back, and we will start the process of everything else that we need to do. Okay, so that light got really weird. Trying to adjust it, but whatever. So basically, this is how my hair looks fresh from being washed. So this is, like I said, this is washed with the As I Am Coconut Cleansing Co-Wash. And my hair is actually, I have some dead ends, some stuff that I snip. But my hair is actually pretty defined for it to have just been washed. For me, that's like insane. Look at that definition, guys. Yes. Okay, so basically what I'm going to do now is, as you see, my hair is still soaking wet. So I'm going to apply my leave-in. No, not my leave-in, my hair mask. I am going to apply my leave-in, my deep conditioner, which is the Superfruit Complex from Shea Moisture 10-in-1 Renewal System Hair Mask. This is another holy grail. I live and breathe this product right here. My hair has never responded so well to a deep conditioner or a hair mask before. I used to use a Cantu hair mask. Granted, it did work nicely. This is a whole nother level, sisters. This is a whole nother level. So, I'm not gonna do this entire thing on camera because this video will just be too long. But I'm going to show you guys how I apply my deep conditioner as well as the tangle. Then I'm just gonna deep condition it for about 30 minutes, which I know is trash, but you know, it's better than nothing. So you get about this size amount right here. There we go. And I haven't like grabbed a section yet, but I'm just... This is what's working for me. So usually I would spread it out between two hands like this. And then I just grab a section. Any section. Usually I do bigger sections, but just for the purpose of this video, I'm just gonna grab a smaller section. This shit ain't random, I didn't get lucky. Made it right here because I'm sick with a cutty. They all take the money for granted, but don't want to work for it. Tell me now, isn't it funny? Definition. I don't know if you guys can really see it, but it's a little bit of definition. I would never use this to like give me a long lasting twist out. So now I am done with these twists, and granted, they look absolutely crazy, especially this one, which is my main 4C right here. This section gives me so much drama. That's why it looks like that. Even when I'm like doing twist knots, this never looks amazing. And this is the part that always fucks up. So anyway, so now I'm gonna go ahead and take my shower cap. And I'm just going to put all of this in there. Make sure every twist is covered. I need to buy new shower caps because these are actually kind of small for when I'm doing my deep conditions, which always sucks. Then I'm just gonna put a bonnet on top. I'm gonna let it sit for 30 minutes and I'll be back to walk my dog. Okay, I'm back. So now that I have rinsed out majority of that mask, I'm gonna go ahead and put my leave-in in and then start the actual wash and go process. So I'm gonna part my hair how I want my wash and go to go. Basically gonna take all this out so that I can like start shaping it and whatever. I'm still trying, y'all. Okay, so I'm gonna part it. I'm not gonna do too much because my hair kind of naturally has a part, which is crazy to me. But it naturally kind of has a middle part. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just kind of go over that part in the middle. I'm gonna part it all the way just like that, because this is how I would want my wash and go to fall. Kind of just like this. So I'm gonna be using my Shea Moisture Jamaican Black Castor Oil Strengthen Grow and Restore Leave-In Conditioner. That is a mouthful. This shit smells horrible. It smells like Play-Doh. I've actually never used this before. I just bought it over this past weekend, or this past Friday. First time using it, so this is kind of like a review of this too. Like I said, I'm not gonna get a crap ton. This is very like, it looks like Play-Doh, like one more plate. So I'm gonna get about that much. Like that. Look at that fucking shrinkage though. My hair in the back is all the way down here. But look at that shrinkage. Like, ugh, kill me. I can't keep a girl no home. Cause as soon as the sun comes up, I cut them all loose and work's my excuse. But the truth is I can't open up. And you don't wanna be. So once again, I'm gonna shake my hair out. You don't ever wanna step off that roller coaster and be all alone. And you don't wanna ride the bus like. Oh, look at the vibrancy. Like, look at how beautiful my hair is when I shake it out like that. If only it would dry like this. Okay, so now I'm gonna start the actual wash and go part, but I have to go get my gel because I forgot it. So I have like so much on my face, but I am attempting a wash and go. We'll see how it looks when it dries. Right now it looks great. Hopefully it stays that way. I was doing a Snapchat, but I'm attempting a wash and go. We'll see how it looks when it dries. Right now it looks great. Hopefully it stays that way. Oh. Quick little plug. You guys should follow me on Snapchat. And here we go. Go ahead, snap. Snap a picture of that. And be my friend on Snapchat. Okay, now that we're done with that self-promo, let's get into it. So the two products that I'll be using today to do this wash and go. The two products that I'll be using today will be the Shea Moisture Coconut and Hibiscus Curl Enhancing Smoothie. I'll be using that as well as You Natural's go-to, but I actually hate gel. But I'm assuming that to get like the full, you know, thing, the full wash and go experience, I'm gonna have to use some gel. So I'm gonna be using my Eco Styler gel with olive oil. So let's get into it. So I'm gonna get this and I'm gonna pull it through this top like I did everything else. And I'm just going to pull it through to try to define. It's getting really wild in here. Really white. Really, really white. So I'm gonna try to keep these sections separate because I'll be putting the gel on here. All right, and I will be using OYU, of course. So now I'm just gonna get my gel about that much. I've never did this before. So work with me if I'm doing some shit wrong. Let me know in the comments below if there's a way that I can do this and make it last or make it look better. I don't know, look at that. Why you gotta be longer than all other hair? I'm gonna put some more gel here. Use those fingers. Use those fingers to define those coils and those curls. So now I'm gonna actually start wiping my hands in between because it's getting gross. Okay, so this is how it looks once I get done putting the gel and everything in. Except now I want to put my oil in it because my hair has all this gel in it and I love for my hair to be nice and oily. So I'm just using virgin coconut oil. So let's go ahead and do this Garnier Fructis commercial. Let's do it, okay? Ugh, look at that definition. I'm going to shake it a little bit more. Because I don't know how it's going to turn out. So, we're hoping for the best, but we're expecting the worst. So yes, my edges are ratchet, I'm aware, but we'll fix those when it's all said and done with. I'm gonna cover my face and shake one more time. I will be back in about 3 hours to tell you guys if it turned out right. My hair takes a really long time to dry. It never dries instantly, so I know that it's gonna take a long time to dry. I'm not gonna put any heat on it because I kinda just want it to. If I had a diffuser, I would, so that it would stop the shrinkage, but I don't have a diffuser, so we're gonna see how it turns out. I'll come back in about 3 hours and let you guys know if I failed or if I succeeded on a 4B, 4C. Watch and go. Okay, so although we are doing this vlog style, I decided that since the sun was setting behind me and it would be kind of hard to get really good lighting, I just set up my filming light behind the camera, and so now I'm going to show you guys how the hair looks. So, it has been probably roughly about 5 hours now, because I think I did that around like 12 o'clock I started my hair, and it's like almost 6 o'clock. So between 5 and 5.5 hours since I first shot that video, my hair is almost completely dry. There is just like a little bit of dampness like right in the back, like right in this area right here. It's still a little damp, so I'm assuming that it's still going to draw up some. But in all honesty, it turned out pretty good. I'm going to get close so you guys can see like the definition. I have some split ends, so if you see those, don't mind. Definition is real. Like, there's definitely some good definition there. Come this way. I'm trying to show you guys. There's some good definition. So all in all, I'd say that this definitely, sorry, I'm scooting back a little bit, that this definitely turned out better than I thought it would. I do wish that it was less shrunk and, you know, like super defined, to the fact that you could just instantly see my coils. But I do have 4B, 4C hair, some 4A. So my coils are really tight and they just, you know, like you can see them, but not like you would see like a 3C, 4A type hair. Whatever the case being, this turned out way better than I thought it would. The shape is great. I think the shape turned out really, really well. It still has plenty of body left. So I think all in all, I would give this like a 7. Not a 10. Definitely not a 10. We're not there yet. I don't know if we'll ever get to a 10, but definitely like a solid 7.5. If we pushing it, an 8. Like, I feel strongly about this. I think it turned out really well.
So with that being said, I'm gonna end this video and say thank you guys so much for watching my first ever like natural based video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope this answered your question of can 4B4C hair wash and go. So I think yes, it can wash and go. Will it look like 3C girls? No, but it can wash and go. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure to give it a big thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe for more videos, hopefully more similar to this. I love you guys so much, and I will see you next time. Bye! I like this filming setup. You gotta keep this.